Okay, so it is the 12th of July. We are here at Jamba. Of course, every Jamba seems to be next to a Starbucks everywhere in the world for some reason. That's interesting. There might be something going on with marketing and Starbucks and Jamba. I'm not sure. Because it's just an awful lot of those.
Mm-hmm. Maybe.
We've had, this was a little down the list, we've had police presence already. Is it directed at me? Not sure, but my guess is because the police walked into the Starbucks really fast. Did he walk out with a coffee?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't?
Mm-hmm.
So Brittany says he didn't have a coffee. He'll mm-hmm. be on camera whether he has a coffee or not. So then why did he walk into Starbucks?
I didn't see him holding a cup. I don't know.
We'll see on the feed when this is all edited together. What the cops might be doing is following me from place to place. Like, Brittany's seen at almost not every place, but a good amount of the places Brittany has seen police presence showing up, trying mm-hmm. to thug and intimidate me and cover up their crime spree. Also, not these pinks showing up now. Okay, so, and then a pink and black showed up as I was getting my coffee bean on the way here, and he honked his horn twice as he saw me getting out of his car, and it was a black guy. Okay, so you've seen, do you remember what locations you've seen the police kind of follow us? Mostly me, not really you, but.
By my office, Westlake.
Oh, that tons of times at our office, mm-hmm. over and over and over, and that wasn't even in public places. That was going into her office.
Yeah.
There's another pink over there. Okay. Now remember, the cops aren't concerned about these groups of people showing up stalking me, trying to set me up and rid me of the world, known as gang stalking. They're only concerned that I might react while being hunted to be killed or eradicated. Okay, and that's the first thought that should be on anyone's mind. Why is it okay to single someone out at 5 years old, hunt them, torture them, kill them with worldwide support and police government support?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now Brittany's office, but more importantly, we went to coffee shops.
What was that one place we went to?
A Panera. Okay, that's the first one. You saw one at Panera.
Mm-hmm.
One, you didn't show up at the Jamba we were supposed to meet at Woodland Hills. And the next day, the cop actually parked in the spot I parked to try to send me a message. Where else? Yes. Monday. Agoura Hills. We're in Westlake Village right now. Agoura Hills. Cops showed up. These are also Ventura County cops.
I need to think about where we were on
the there are, I think, two other locations.
Oh, I remember. Sorry. My brain.
Do you remember?
No, I do. I don't know about Camarillo, but Agoura, yeah.
So Agoura, Westlake, Thousand Oaks.
What about Woodland Hills?
Where did we
do? Place, I remember. Shopping center? It was a Jamba, right? Where that guy came in on camera behind us and stuff when it was like freezing out.
I can't remember. I mean, we've been.
That was
the point
house
is
home.
That I think we've had about four police presence all across from LA County to Ventura County. And almost every person I'm in contact with is in an anger or rage starting at 5 years old because I was born. It doesn't make any sense.
Oh, I wasn't going to ask you. You went to the beach last night, you said?
Yeah, yesterday.
Did you take pictures?
No, I just wanted to chill out and try to get my energy back.
Good, I'm glad
but
you did
that. I did video one thing. Maybe this is, I'll splice this in. We're actually recording right now. Okay, there's this thing, like I found a spot where nobody goes to.
Cool, yeah.
You can only fit like maybe three other cars tops on the PCH. Because they all follow me. The spot I went before at Point Magoo, groups of new cars showed up and Asians and trying to spook me and do things. So I found a spot that's a little bit more secluded.
Mm-hmm.
And so what happens is, like, I'm in the car and I'll walk out of the car. Like, maybe I'm in the car for an hour and I'll walk out of the car and then groups of people will show up.
Okay.
And you're not 100% sure, but you're like, the timing. Because
right.
You noticed the cop went quickly into Starbucks and he didn't spend much time. Okay,
yeah,
so.
What is that about?
He's probably asking him if I went in or something. Okay, so the timing So anyways, yesterday I want to prove a point. So I go there, I'm there for about an hour and a half. I turn on my video camera, and I'm like, I'm going to go take a little tinkle in the bushes over here and hide. Nobody's going to see me, whatever. And what's going on, I explain. Either they're tracking my GPS or something on my cell phone, or there's something in my car that's letting them know when I get out of my car.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Maybe it's audio on the phone. I'm not sure. So, and cars are probably going to show up when I leave my car. Now, remember, I've been there for an hour and a half. No cars have showed up. I go for less than a couple minutes, come back, as I'm walking back, four cars show up. And the first three pull by the door, my driver's door, sit there waiting with their lights on, trying to, like, we're watching you, to intimidate you. And then another guy with, of course, an Asian, he pulls up behind and he talks to the Asian. The Asian sort of girl's talking, has a camera, and she's talking to the guy, and she's doing some of the cryptic yes, yes things, sort of trying to trigger me. And, right, you get the idea that, what are the chances that I talk about that in the camera, it goes from zero to four,
it's weird,
and then no other cars come the entire night.
Right.
All on camera. And I did not stop the camera, so you can see the timing, how long it took them to get there. I stayed on the camera, people are probably waiting right down the road there for me to get out of my car, and
you
bam, like, there it is, right?
You said it before.
Yeah, and so, okay, so anyways, we're wasting a lot of time, so let's start this
thing. I think that was important, though, yeah.
It is important. It's just I have so much video like that. It's like, how do you integrate it? Okay, we're at Point Magoo. Notice the two blues in the corner here. What else we got? A cruise who's leaving. But, wait, this is a Toyota Yaris and a blue Civic. And a bunch of beer. Okay. No one in each. Now I bet he goes to the spot where I'm gonna go to next or something. Also, let's look who's pulling up because he sort of knew to leave when I got here. Now we have looks like a black Lexus. And I'll just video. The guy has a Santa Cruz shirt, and the only reason I'm videoing that is because he's probably hinting about my old skateboard, Santa Cruz Slasher, which the government says is somehow a crime, right? By buying a skateboard at 13 called a Santa Cruz Slasher. Okay, so notice a girl pulls up matching clothes, black shirt, blue jeans, Asian girl. And this is an Asian guy in another blue car with the other blue car. So two Asian groups have pulled up. Okay, so notice more blue cars showing up, and over here, a blue Explorer, right? So this lady came out perfect. Also, this is kind of like my car, but a white version, the newer one. Quickly go around to this side. I don't see anything too weird yet. A couple of LA hats and then another blue car over here. Now, okay, nobody's actually here. Something seems different. I don't remember all this pavement here. Anyways, so there was a Andy Gump here. This is like my little spot. It looks like they repaved it. I don't know why. Once in a while, there's some fishermen down there. It's pretty secluded. And then there's not much room. Maybe two more, three more cars can kind of come out. But I like it. because it's away from everyone, because as you've seen, everywhere I go, people follow me, and they follow me here too in mass groups, stalking me. But it's a little better. I'm going to take a pee. Notice how there's nobody here. So every time what happens is, and this time I'm not going to take my cell phone, but normally I take my cell phone and I take a leak over here. And someone shows up in a car instantly after. But I always take my cell phone. And they know instantly when I get out of my car and go here. So how do they know? Well, they're probably looking at the GPS and see when the GPS moves. And then they know to show up waiting down the street. So today, I'm just going to simply leave the camera on the dash and see if someone shows up when I go take a pee-pee. Okay, so notice, right here, like I said, a car just pulled up. I left my car, I walked out of my car, I haven't stopped videoing, I told you what was going to happen, no cars have been behind me. Instantly, when I walked out, walked down there, took a leak, came back, here's a car waiting by my door with the lights on. Right? How did I know that happened? Now, well, first let's break down what we know. All the other times I took the phone, and I figure they know because, maybe the GPS on the cell phone, or maybe they're like streaming audio or something out of my phone. But the point is, instantly, nobody's been here for about an hour and a half, instantly walking out of my car, walking here for a couple minutes, coming back, someone from down the street pulled up waiting with the lights on by my door. Right? Just like I told you would happen. So now how did they know that I was going to leave my car? That's the big question. They're obviously not tracking the GPS, but they knew when I was going to exit my car for someone from down the road. She's in 6TCH 102 is the car. They instantly knew when I got out of my car from down the street and pulled up waiting by my door. Right? So it's got to be something with technology, probably my phone, or possibly even something in my car that was put in my car, with the endless resources and worldwide support, to sort of track when I get out of my car, right? Or maybe even someone driving by texting, he just got out of his car, but I would think that would take a little longer. You see, but right now it's on video. I told you what was going to happen before it happened, and it happened. And maybe we'll test the waters again, but it happens every single time they know when I get out of my car. So if someone put cameras at one of the auto repair shops, okay, now we have another person. They're going to do the same thing. In a red car. Pulling to the side. They got a GPS. He's looking at his GPS. It's in a red, what do you call this? Tesla. Right? People know to pull right to the side there when I walk out of my car. Normally they pull right behind me and they stake out for a while. Last time I was here, all sorts of things were happening as they put an Andy Gump here that they locked. But why didn't anyone do that? In the last hour, nobody really pulled by did that except for one black pickup. But instantly they knew right when I walked out of my car. That's what's most important. So something with my phone or my car is sending out to these mass groups, and they're using some kind of technology to sort of track on the most minute detail when I exit my car. Now let's kind of go on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram and see what the comments are, because there's probably something related from people around the world. Let's see. To this little event, which happens every waking moment of my life, to try to create paranoia, make me look crazy. Let's see. Don't see anything on Twitter. Let's look at Facebook. Let's just... Don't see any of the normal messages, hidden message on Twitter, or haven't checked Facebook. Okay, another guy with an engine car here is now pulling behind me. So I've been here an hour, nobody's been here. Instantly when I walked out of my car and went back there, three cars have now shown up working the same tactics, and here's a fourth. So they knew when I exited my car. Instantly. There's four cars have now shown up within less than 10 minutes from me walking out of my car and going down 20 feet down this little trail and coming back. Right? Four cars. Okay. So this knows how this guy's pulled up over there. I better switch batteries. This one's dead because they're now ramping up their attacks when I walked out of my car. Okay, so now these two guys are over here. They've pulled to the side, these two separate people. And I don't think these people are together either. I think they're separate, but they were notified, okay, at this point, go to where Kevin is. So you know they were down the street. They were down the street.
waiting for me to get out of my car, and four cars showed up instantly, just like I told you would happen. So I'm just going to kind of leave the camera running for a short while, because we've proven what's going on. Okay. Also, I just noticed this. The shoes up there. I think that's from the movie, like, Big Fish or something.
And then, like, you heard the audio recordings of Richard Barnwell. What do you say? My criminal plight or something like that, right? My criminal. What's my criminal? Well, we don't have an argument. It's a lawyer without an argument. Gee. I mean, does that... Right?
He sounded very, like... I've never heard some. He was very.
And they're all like that. That just pure rage in their voice, and you need to die, and if you're a criminal, and it's like, well, but don't you have an argument as to why I'm a criminal, as to what I've done? No, right? Mm-hmm. You're just your criminal business tactics for building websites like Vibster, or the big one they're angry about is Erotic Ranch, which is just a Facebook adult level Facebook. What's the criminal?
There is
except I was giving, I was, what was it? It was a contract for 50%, stating I do all the work for free. Okay, we're talking about they're calling a guy that's doing all the work for free a criminal, and you make up on the back end a percent of the profits from your marketing because you're the chick or whatever, and I don't have time to... I'm not a marketing agency. I'm a developer.
Yeah.
Okay? And then I started integrating it into a database and SQL system called Erotic Ranch. And according to these people, some guy that goes out and invests years and asks for not one penny is the criminal, but not the person that gets everything for free. Right?
I didn't realize that was all for free. Like, you did that...
They got everything for free. And I spent years and years building the system. Everything. It's like if I walked up to you and I said, here's the card, here's the title, here's this, here's that, just, you know, 10 years from now, just pay it forward. Oh, you're a criminal, you need to die with worldwide support. Okay, but what's the criminal part? I didn't take your money.
No, there's
nothing. I went out, I sweat for you, I asked for zero in return.
I didn't realize that you did that just...
Oh, yeah, yeah, and like Aubrey Fisher. Okay, like, remember we talked about Aubrey Fisher and she putting up the pictures of boys, children... It was like a, who knows, like an 8-year-old boy with no shirt on at the beach, and she's asking me these interrogatory questions, like she's a detective.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think this, trying to make it look like I'm a pedophile,
and like spewing totally this out to the world.
Now, what did I do to Aubrey Fisher? We talked about her a little before. She befriends me, just like Victoria Walker. Kevin, will you do this for me? Kevin, will you do that for me? Well, I have this pre-built database, Erotic Ranch system. Here, I'll put your photography website for free for you, and my payback in return is to hunt me down and kill me with the police and government for going out of my way for a friend, just like the things I was doing for Tom Farley. Kevin, my dad's gonna fire me, and we need to go to a website, and I'll build this shopping cart code for you for free in a day, and there, you don't have to build 1,000 product pages by hand. I just built one page that'll do it all for you. Oh, Kevin's a criminal and needs to be hunted and killed. Wait, these are my friends, right?
And you were a good friend. You did this stuff and didn't ask for anything. You wanted to help
you
people.
You do things like that for... I mean, everyone does do things like that for their friends.
But you did that repeatedly just to help.
Correct. Because that's what friendship is about, is building the bond and the trust and doing things for your friend and being there for them and going on your way, when whether it's the shit hits the fan or whatever, like me giving Tom housing when he had nowhere to go. I mean, that's what friends do, to find out that your friends are all using it against you. He becomes a criminal because he gave me free housing, and I'm going to try to get in his house to get whatever I can to use against him. Right, I mean, so do you understand that they never were my friends from day one, right? But they latched on like a stalking murderer, which they are, and they pursued me and hunted me to try to rid me of the world, and then they turn around. Okay, so that brings me to the next... The next thing, Nico.
Have you talked to her?
No, I cut all contact because Nico, I'm going to just throw a label, is one of them. Does that make sense?
The, like,
and you're going to hear it right now. because now she's trying to reel me in to set me up to make it attack my character. Does that make sense?
Okay.
To make their lies look true. Same thing they always do. They all do. Posing as a gang stalking target. Which is very convincing.
And yeah. And last time I talked to you, you weren't quite like sure.
I was on the fence because, and I'll explain why.
To saved messages.
Let's see.
Saved message. Sorry, Tom, I started. Message saved. Saved message. Kevin, it's Nico down the street. Wanted to see if you wanted to hang out today. I want to do something about these people parking in front of my house because it's so frequent that I just want to start reporting it and just taking it directly to the police or the DA's office because I'm sick of these people pulling up one after the other in succession. And, of course, I've got a whole row of people parked on my block that don't live here. So, and I haven't heard from you. Anyways, I took a Doppler picture of the air above my house, and yes, you can clearly see that there was poison being dumped over my property this morning in Woodland Hills. So I took a screenshot of it, and I did send it to two different people by text message. And I have been checking weatherbug.com after that fact, and suddenly, mysteriously, the sky looks better, which is ridiculous because it's only been a couple of hours since I took that screenshot. So, either way, I'm just down the street here, Nico. Give me a call back, okay? Okay, bye, because I want to do something about capturing the faces of these people that are driving these cars that are parked in front of my house. I have a white truck parked out front right now. So, anyway, hope to hear from you. Bye.
Okay, well, on the surface, it sounds like someone that just lost all their shit, right?
And she's looking for, like, a friend or something.
Well, that's what it sounds like on the surface. Yeah. And she's very convincing, not like the other ones.
Yeah.
I doubt you saw the El Pollo Loco guy, which I'm still editing the other parts of the spit from the cigar shop, where you can instantly tell his guys are implanting dreams, whatever. And the way he talks, you can tell he's full of shit, right?
Mm-hmm.
But she's very convincing, and you can hear the anger, like the upset.
Absolutely.
Or the anxiety in her voice. But then she switches to these abusive setups or... Now, first I want you to sort of analyze the way she's talking on vagueness. People, I want you to help me video these people who keep parking in front of my street.
Mm-hmm.
But she never really says they did anything wrong,
except they don't live
people
here.
That don't live here parked on my street. Okay? Yeah. Well, that's not wrong. That's not a crime. There's nothing.
She talked about that before, like that they're like stalking her. Is that what she's saying?
Well, she's saying that she's the target.
Right.
But this is the point. She's doing what everyone's doing to me. Okay? Kevin, we don't want you parking on the street because you don't live here.
Oh.
Or, example, you need to put your car in your garage.
Okay.
And if you park the car on the street, we're gonna have all the people come out and try to make you mentally ill with our cars. Kevin, if you take a walk down your street by the Metro Complex, Warner Center Met, mm-hmm. which surrounds my place, you're not allowed to walk away from your house and down in our area, like dogs that piss and mark their territory, right? So she's coming off with the very same paranoid, psychotic behaviors that my family is, right?
Okay.
Okay, it's not about people committing crimes against her, even though she says it is. It's about you're invading my personal bubble, which is like 1,000 miles long, right? There's people that don't live here parking cars on a public street. Well, that's what people do on public streets. This parking is for the public, and people scatter and find public parking spaces.
Mm-hmm.
So now Kevin helped me do these things. Danger, Will Robinson.
Right.
Danger, right? Because their argument is that I'm lashing out in rage. I'm doing these things to all Starbucks people. I'm doing these things at Jamba.
Everybody.
I'm doing all these thousands of cars parked in these patterns. I'm doing it to all these people.
Yeah.
They're doing it to me, and then I have a logical and rational argument, which is scarier than shit, that look what these people are doing. The hundreds of people at the same time coming in pink clothes, the groups of green and black, the lady sitting here going, wow, to try to provoke me about Wowzers, Alexis Amore, based on them putting government-level NSA spyware and tracking on my computer since 1994 to try to get anything off the computer they can twist and contort and use against me, mm-hmm. of Alexis Amore saying, wow, on one of her videos, movies, right? And then trying to make it look like I'm a violent paranoid schizo and saying that I said it, and then people showing up in groups following me to Starbucks all around the world going, wow, as they walk by, to try to trigger me and make it look like I'm a violent paranoid schizo.
Did your phone, is it still on? I heard a beep, so I just wanted to make sure.
No, I don't think it is.
Oh, do you need it? Or no, it's not connected,
no,
huh?
No, it's just,
okay.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
Yeah, sorry. So now we have the monitor.
Okay,
so, my arguments are all logical, rational, factual, non-aggressive, non-abusive, mm-hmm. very observing and exposing, because you can only sit for the first 10 years going, when's this going to end? Right? Yeah, and then you hear the lawyers angry at me like, well, you went out and tried to make money. Or I don't like you because when you went to Southern Oregon State College, you took a forensics class in your list of general requirements.
That's ridiculous.
Isn't it ridiculous?
It is. Like,
so what? they're collecting whatever they can collect and use. Okay, now anyone that goes to college knows that you have a list of requirements and you just take random classes to fulfill the requirements. Yeah. So what would your life be like if someone's collecting every single class you take and go, I don't like, you're a bad person because you took this class.
Then
you can't take any. Correct. And then you would say, well, why do you offer the class if people are going to be hunted and killed for it?
Right.
Right?
Right. It doesn't make any sense.
Okay, so.
And can I scoot this just a
sure.
tiny bit forward, like this? Yeah.
Okay. So my life, no matter how perfect I am, they're building this insane NSA-level case of fabricated fictional bullshit.
That's why I was asking, like, you help people without asking for anything in return. You do all these nice kind
Correct.
Of things.
Correct. Every single thing on every level is collected, twisted, and corded. It doesn't matter. I go out and walk up to stranger after stranger and hand them a gold brick. Each and every one will hunt me down and try to kill them.
It doesn't make sense. It's like, are you too good, like good.
There's no such thing as too good.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
And nobody is too
good. That.
I mean, I'm a human.
But
I'm good.
Good morals,
I'm happy.
You help
I'm
people.
Sad. I'm angry.
Absolutely.
I'm depressed. I'm
but like overall.
Innovative. I don't know. You know, they change and switch from minute to minute. There's no such thing. And that was some of our first conversations.
Yeah.
Was putting mental illness labels. Well, you broke up with a girl, so you're depressed for a week, so you suffer from depression, and you'd be locked away in a mental institution for the rest of your life.
No, that's a normal response to a breakup.
Correct. Yeah. And so my family can't understand this. They can't understand fluctuations or contexts or anything else.
Do you feel like they want to make it more than it is then? Or do you think they really don't get it?
No, they have motive. There's one person that fits that insanity, sure, happens. All of them working together.
Yeah.
We could take it to the next level. Well, it's genetic. My brother's a psychotic murderer. My mother's a psychotic murderer. My father's a psychotic murderer. But my brother's friends and my friends and
everyone.
Okay, so we had to move. The camera was in the sun and the sensor overheated. And another thing I wanted to sort of talk about is the police also showed up, and I'm wearing a shirt. It says, just do it. And the reason I ordered the shirt the other day is because we talked about in our last two conversations, we talked about Tom Farley. Tom Farley is directly linked to the Persian groups at Coffee Bean and Starbucks stalking me for the last 18 years,
mm-hmm.
where he talks about how he's Greek and he's Pontian Greek, and because the Greek and Persian wars in, like, who knows, like 8,000 BC or something. I mean, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And he's talking about, so this is why he hates Greeks or Persians, and then all of a sudden the Persian groups start hunting me down worldwide, showing that he's playing these games like, I say something to you that I hate these people, then they come after me.
Right.
Right?
Like it's
They're
put
schizo
on you
games.
Or something.
Yeah. Like he's pretending that I said it. He's telling me one thing and he's telling everyone else that Kevin said this and Kevin said that.
Right.
Okay, so We were talking about something extremely important, and
your parents' groups being organized.
Colleges, my family's psychotic, paranoid psychotic behaviors. Classes in college, like.
Here, you need a something on top of that.
Taking a forensics class, which was a general.
That's what, general ed or something.
General courses in colleges before selecting your major or during your major, everyone does, and unless you don't have a college degree and you're ignorant and you don't know what college is like, they're trying to sort of nitpick that with everything else. Well, he's schizo and he thinks he's a detective because
he took
a forensics class, which is just a list of, I don't remember. How many requirements you have to take in your basic
bachelor? I don't know. There's several.
What is it called? Bachelor of... Your bachelor's degree before selecting the major or during, you have to take something like 50 courses.
Like general education,
classes that don't apply to anything, and everyone has to do it.
Yeah.
So you can't sit there and nitpick each class someone takes and go, they're crazy because this, they're crazy because they took that.
No, because everybody has to.
Yeah, it has nothing to do with anything, like everything else. And so they apply that to every aspect of life. So now, did I just say it? So anyways, the shirt, the guy just there said, hey, you know, I love your shirt, blah, 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 and he gave me like the...
I'm part of the tribe.
The punch, I'm part of the tribe, as if it's some kind of cult and it's just not some harmless joke, right? And just like they're hunting me down...
Sorry, how do you, I guess you learn to like differentiate that from like just a genuine like, hey, that's a sweet
because
shirt,
it's based
you
on
know?
A certain set of repetitive...
Right.
Patterns.
That's what I'm saying, because it could appear like
pantomimes. And I'm not joking. I'm like the mobster in True Romance, where he talks about facial pantomimes, whatever.
What's a pantomime?
It's like a human behavioral gesture or a facial expression.
Oh, okay.
So you can tell if someone's being honest or truthful based on their facial expressions. Like the guy that came up to El Pollo Loco, follow me to El Pollo Loco, you could tell from his facial expressions and the way he's talking and his body language
that he wasn't
he's full
friendly.
Of shit.
Okay.
And you can tell from Nico that she it's harder to tell. I haven't seen her in person.
I haven't met her in person either.
But her voice is very upset. Anxiety, upset.
Distressed, yeah.
Distressed. And so she sounds more legit, but then the thing she's doing, and another thing is she sends me a text here. This is very strange, she's done this twice. She talks about earthquakes, then we have the earthquakes a couple days ago. Yesterday, she sends me a text about going to a rally in Oregon, where I went to Southern Oregon State College.
Mm-hmm.
And that was yesterday morning, and I had a nap during the afternoon, and I had a dream about my friends in Southern Oregon State College, Chuck and John, and going in a van or a bus out towards a rally-ish type of thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And so I'm not going there. I'm not going down that path. But all the little intricate things, the things she says, all seem to be collected things about my life and mimicky and trying to get me to go down a path that makes me look crazy.
Okay.
Whether I'm right or wrong.
It feels like more than just a coincidence.
Correct.
So.
It's on the red flag, break contact.
Okay.
And when she's, as we heard on the thing, she keeps talking about people pouring poisons, and my father, when she saw the video of my father trying to break in my house, someone's pouring poison on him, and I mean, you know, these are, they have nothing to do with gang stalking.
Okay.
Right.
I don't know.
Gang stalking is the act of groups trying to make someone look crazy, and when you're talking about imaginary poisons and gases and this and that, that's fiction. That's fantasy.
Mm-hmm.
Unless she should somehow prove it. But when she starts telling me that the video of my father, there's poison being dumped on him as he's going to my door, well, you know, she's analyzing things you can't see. And if she's analyzing things you can't see, everything I'm talking is logical and factual. Hey, 10 people showed up with black pants and green shirts.
Yeah, you can't deny that.
Yeah, and it's on video. Okay, yeah. So she comes off as someone that's kind of crazy and people are making fun of her and abusing her because of it,
mm-hmm.
which you could also call gang stalking because of groups or following her from place to place, going, you're crazy, let's make fun of the crazy person, and torturing them to rid them of the world, then yeah, that is classified as gang stalking. But she doesn't sound credible.
Okay.
But then when she starts sort of reeling me into the things that make their arguments look valid on my behalf. Hey, Kevin's territorial and he's trying to run people out of everywhere he goes.
Right.
Well, it's the opposite.
Absolutely.
And when she starts talking about cars, help me get rid of these people that are parking in front of my house when they haven't done anything wrong, then that's what they're doing to me.
So it makes you like...
If I feed into that, see, I told you so, Kevin's full of shit, right?
Your red flags are up.
Because it's my actions, and my actions have always shown that I've done nothing wrong, and I'm being hunted, and they keep making up lies. Once she manipulates me down that road, manipulates,
right.
Did I make the point?
Yes.
Okay, so,
then your flags are way up. Then they can say something.
And that's when my flags go up, going, this person doesn't look legit, because I've now seen about 10 of these manipulations.
Like, exactly like this?
Similar. Didn't see, which I'm not sure is even working for LAPD anymore, posts how they're cranking down on dogs at Serenia Park with dog walkers with no leashes, as if anyone gives a flying fuck. Right?
Okay.
Dincy's helping them. Yeah, this is recent. And Dincy's helping them crank down on dog walkers without leashes, because not having a leash on a dog is a crime. Well, that fits in the category of jaywalking is also a crime, but you would never give a shit. Right?
You look like
a complete ass puppet if you're going after jaywalkers. like Dincy's 1.5 inches in the red on my car.
Right.
Kevin, you want to take a walk with me? You know, I want to go to that park by DeSoto, Serenia Park. Well, why do you want me to go where Dincy just posted?
Okay.
And there's been several other things like this, and I'm just like, stay away, you know?
Yeah, because last time we met, you said she's volatile, right?
Like, it seems like a volatile relationship. Now, remember, my life isn't based on you hung around someone that isn't kosher or is crazy. Normally, people would go, well, that person's a little off, and, you know, you're just hanging around with someone nuts. In my life, it's different because they're trying to set me up and make it look like I'm a criminal to lock me away in jail cells and mental institutions for whatever reasons. It's five.
For no reason.
So the point is that at the same time, two gang-stalking target wannabe victims have come in my life, and the other one was more aggressive with the attacks after, with the man tactic and all the stores and people following me going man over and over in anger and rage that he couldn't scare me quiet, right? Nico's more stealth, like, come help me do this, come help me do that. She's more convincing, but it's the Victoria Walker, hey, Rhodey Morales, befriend Kevin, take Kevin to strip clubs, I'm going to work on the... call Kevin up on the phone, go to this website, there's Stefania, the Latin girl who has escort ads, and then Stefania follows me to foreplay and Spearmint Rhino, befriending me.
Are those strip clubs?
Yeah, the strip clubs. And she'd sit with me for like hours and talk, and then this would go on for years.
Right.
And the whole time, you don't know that they're sort of putting together this...
Why would you?
Kevin's stalking and... Oh. Their argument's something like, well, Kevin went to a website, he saw her, he followed her to a strip club, reversing it.
Okay.
And this goes from person to person since 5 years old.
Right.
Okay. So the Victoria Walker come in, or Nico, her very first email doesn't even mention gang stalking. It mentions she has a garage, she's a makeup artist and has a garage and wants to start a studio.
Do work, yeah.
So it appears as work, and then it shifts to she's crazy, then it shifts to, will you do these things with me or for me? And we're seeing cops show up, following me from place to place. We have lawyers saying that I'm a criminal for some reason, but they have no argument why.
I'll tell you why.
There's me exposing person after person for 47 years doing the same thing on a daily basis, and everyone's saying, you don't talk or we kill you.
Right, and they don't see it.
Yeah, it's very strange.
It's very hard to deny that you see, like, these factual things, like the clothing, you know? Like...
It's hard to believe that you could coordinate worldwide groups.
Right, but like, it's also like you're seeing it, though, you know? Like, Yeah, it's hard to...
I'm seeing it. You've seen... I mean, well, you said on video like 100 times. You're seeing it, right? I mean...
I'm saying, like, how can you deny, like, the clothing colors and patterns that they're wearing?
Yeah, and you learn to read it like Braille. Like, for example, here comes a yellow and black, black pants, yellow shirt. Now, that is one of the tactics. Is this guy involved? I can't tell you because it's just one. But more importantly, as I was pointing out to Brittany, at entering the lot, we have two yellow/yellow-black, because the tires are black, cars close to each other by the entrance, and that is not coincidence, and I can explain the reasoning and why. This entire lot has no...
backwards?
What is it, 2,000 cars? There's not one yellow car in this lot, except two close to each other over there, just like the pairs of twos backwards from lot to lot, in showing people migrating together and things like that, where they're contacted and told to do so, are all directed at me. Who knows why? Okay, so anyways, we haven't even started this.
I know.
Okay. And we tend to do this. It is...
40 after?
144. 1144.
144.
Wait, 144.
Yeah.
You have till 2, what?
30.
2:30. So we got to sort of speed this up a little. Okay, so... on the top of my notes, police presence at multiple locations. We've just seen it here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the other place was the Starbucks and Jamba Juice in Thousand Oaks, where the Mike Wexler lookalikes and
the one I saw on video
lookalikes.
Oh, yeah,
we went there.
Okay, I know. I remember.
With the blue jean, the groups of 20 people in all black and the blue jean and pink shirt groups all came in.
I remember.
And the cop came back twice. I got him on video showing up, and then I got him on video leaving before I parked. And then when you arrived, I got out and I knew he was coming back. I had a good idea he was coming back, and I got on video showing that it was directed at me.
Mm-hmm.
And here too, right? On these thugging intimidation tactics, and we're not even in, I don't even live here, I live in Woodland Hills.
Right.
We're in Ventura County. I live in LA County. Showing you the magnitude that this will have, I could fly to New York right now.
Wouldn't matter.
Same thing with Brittany here by myself, same thing would happen, trying to set me up or get anything to use against me, and you're imagining it.
Right.
So my point is that before I even met Brittany, cops were following me to coffee shop, to coffee shop, to coffee shop. Therapy sessions to therapy sessions.
With other therapists and
oh,
stuff?
Yeah. Okay. Kareen Eshigan, all sorts of things.
Is she the first one, too?
No, she's not the first. She's just the one that really showed her true colors, because I was trying to do group therapy with my father, and she was getting private. The entire conversations with Lorena Escobar, my father's office manager, and it was all being disseminated worldwide, like most of them. Showing that my father didn't want me talking, and my father wasn't concerned about resolving anything.
Right.
Okay, so...
I didn't realize that you had tried to do family sessions.
Oh, yeah, you know,
stuff.
But you just start to understand that they're like murderers, and they don't care about right or wrong, or relationships. Remember, our last topic was about control, and controlling your other.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I'm going to date you, but I'm going to control you.
Yeah.
Well, that's not a relationship.
No.
That's some fictional mafia movie. You know, maybe in the mafia, I can't tell you, but that would be like 1% of society would be like that, right?
Yeah.
Hey, I want to date you, but you do everything I tell you, and you're only allowed to sit at park benches for 10 minutes, or groups of neighbors come out of their house torturing you.
That's called an abusive relationship.
Yeah, but still, even in an abusive relationship, who has the resources to tell every neighbor in your...
Right.
Right. That's NSA level murder operations. That's not control. So
exactly.
This fictional ideal of control that they're trying to make me think is real, it's not. It's something else. Okay, so...
your father sabotaging
me. Okay, recap. Father sabotaging me before something happens, saying with his mentality that he has to save me from myself. I think we're talking about me starting one of my web-based... Vibester or whatever companies that was a MySpace/build-your-own-website technology database/ HTML JavaScript, and you could customize on almost any level if you knew what you were doing, and then upload all your art and portfolio, and it turns into a community environment where you could post your portfolio of new music or whatever that integrated all sorts of things. Past this time now, past this window. digging around about copyright issues or this before it ever happens, sabotaging it and contacting all the programmers before it happens, right?
Because you reached out dangerous. To so many.
Yeah, and he was doing the same thing with building cars at 16 years old, telling everyone worldwide that I stole $10,000 from him.
Didn't somebody else steal that money, right? Or was that a different situation?
I don't think the money was ever stolen at
all. Oh, okay.
But what my father said, my father comes up to me. My father's dating a French lady named Alexandra. My brother and his friends are supposedly doing whatever it takes to get rid of her. They were flooding the house, hinting that they're gonna pop my bladder while destroying the house. My brother is telling me that he and his friends are pissing and shitting in her convertible. Ew. Which for some reason she's leaving her top down for months parked on the road. I don't know why.
Right.
My friend Paul starts coming in. Kevin, I'm pissing and shitting in Alexander's car. I never saw one of them do it.
Right, they're just telling you this.
I know now they're trying to peer pressure me into doing it. Find out after 29 worldwide groups are coming after me for supposedly sabotaging my father's girlfriends.
Right.
You see
when
a connection here?
To do with it. Yeah.
Also with my brother telling me he and his friends are going to put me in a mental institution while worldwide groups are trying to put me in a mental institution. So all these things are linking back to my brother and family. Right. Trying to frame me or set me
Your
up.
Your brother's always not been kind to you, right? Like even grown up?
Well, no. He's like the rest of the family. To your face, he's a really nice guy.
Okay.
Behind your back, there's these really freaky operations with the police and government and NSA. To your face, it's like, I love you and you're great and come visit me and see your nephew. And then these things happen like, hey, you know, I want you to meet this redhead girl nurse that I know and blah, blah, blah. And you go out on one date and it's okay. It's not amazing. It's not, but it's okay. You don't.
It's decent.
You kind of go, okay, you know, I'll go out on another date. And she says, you know, let's go out later this week while you're in town. And all of a sudden, your brother flips out on you for no reason at all, saying, you know, Kevin, she's not in love with you and this and that, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
And you're like, once again, am I in a fucking Twilight Zone?
Exactly.
Nothing happened. Nothing happened. I didn't jump on her saying, here's a wedding ring and blah, blah, blah. Nothing happened. We didn't even make it to the second date.
Okay. You didn't go on a second one.
And then I see her maybe a couple years later coming back to visit my brother, and she's angry at me, like I did something to her. And she's trying to belittle me and undermine me with another guy. And you're like, am I in a Twilight Zone?
Am I missing something?
All I did was say, sure, I'll go on another date. And my brother's like, you're a dead man.
For no reason.
Correct. And you're always made to look like this crazy person based on thin air. Everything. Even today. Even sitting right there. Sitting down watching groups of people with the wow, 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 wow. The other guy looking at me putting his feet up on a chair. Cops coming out. Well, we're checking out Kevin to make sure he doesn't do anything to these poor innocent people who are literally following me and waiting for me and working on me just like my brother. And once again, it's back to the same argument. How's it going from stranger to stranger? All coordinated with internet-based resources. I lost some paperwork. Where
did you?
Do you have it or no? What paperwork do you have?
I have the one you gave me, the three.
Nothing
sheet.
By itself. Maybe I didn't.
This one? That was the one by itself.
Oh, I didn't bring it. It was a printout of the appeals. Seymour had an appeals the 11th.
Oh.
He gave the oral argument. I guess the respondent gave the oral argument. We're waiting for decision. But what I found interesting was that on the 10th, a judge, I can't remember the legal term, but there was something conflicting and he
threw it out?
No, he didn't throw it out, but the judge himself couldn't be part of it. Some kind of
Wait,
conflict.
Wait, what?
I'll bring the paper
like
next
you knew,
time.
Like he knew you
It
or
says
something?
Judge, I can't tell you. Sanjay something, looked Indian. Most of my programmers were Indian. From India.
Like a conflict of interest or something?
Conflict of interest thing. Something like that.
Weird.
I've never been to appeals. I didn't show up in person. I figured they're going to get angry if they see me, even though.
You didn't have to go, right?
No, it's just an oral argument. It's not criminal, anyways. It's to try to overturn the criminal. Whatever. It's just something I was going
to
give you the paperwork.
And
it looked a little strange.
More?
I did, yeah.
What did he say?
You know, vague like usual. Okay, we did it. Now they're going to throw in their opinion, and we're going to wait for that. And I think I called again saying, well, more specific, what did you do on the criminal aspect, because it sounded like Seymour from day one was focused for some reason, was like, I want to get it overturned to show that you can pass out cards, because down in LA, there's a, just like jaywalking, this is only in downtown LA, there's a tiny little code that says no handbills on cars. Nobody gives a shit.
What's a handbill?
A handbill is a piece of paper, like a flyer or whatever.
Okay.
Well, nobody gives a shit. No. So, Seymour's pretending in the beginning to focus on, hey, this is an important issue. We're going to change policy for putting a piece of paper on a car. I mean,
right.
Granted, that law shouldn't be in place. That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. This isn't about that. This is about something much bigger than a piece of paper on a car. Okay, so anyways, connection between... So my father sabotaging, I don't want you to go out and make money because you could do something harmful to yourself.
Right.
Well, but you can't, that's like saying I'm not going to date a woman because she could break up with me and I can be depressed.
Right. Then
okay.
You can't,
it's like, you got to go out and you got to live your, you can't,
you have to try.
What did I used to call it? The what-ifers. I used to call them what-ifers.
Right.
People walk around all day. What if this happens? What if that happens? What if,
worry,
why do you have a
everything.
Camera? Why did you take a picture of that tree? Why did you take a picture of that girl? Why did you go to the beach and take a picture? What if this happens? What if that happens? That's neurotic. That's insane. That's my mother.
Okay.
Okay? And then you have the father. Well, you know, I gotta pay off people to hunt you down because you could do something that's gonna harm yourself. So I'm gonna do the damage instead of them.
Right.
Right? But what's it really about?
Control.
Control. I'm Dr. Ronald Barry Pearl, and I have Golden State Sports Medical, and I don't want my son doing something that could
make me
guilt by association my name. And in reality, that's not how life works. Okay,
right.
People don't. You see that guy over there? He got a lap dance from a stripper 10 years ago. We have to kill him. That's not how it works.
No, no.
Okay?
No.
Nothing's going to happen to my father's company unless my father, tries to kill me or something,
right,
showing he's a murderer, and it's not guilt by association, especially the guy that hangs out with David Greenstein, lawyer David Greenstein, who sues people for a living illegally and things like that.
Right.
Then he tells me things that he can't fire people because he could get sued. Yeah, okay, so he's going to hunt down and kill
his son?
Them, right, instead.
Oh.
Because he doesn't want to get sued. Okay, so I'm just sort of noticing some of the green shirts that may or may not be. So the point is that everything my father says is full of shit. He's insane. And it's all about stopping me on every level.
From living
sabotaging before I can accomplish anything with the rest of my family. Okay, so, and... Mike Huntley at 14, Kevin, meet Melody the stripper, now we're going to hunt you down because guilt by association, look what you did this to your life, but nobody was going to care about something like that.
Not at all.
Okay, so Dinsey's recent arrest cover, where am I? Connection between sitting on the sidewalk arrest 2013 with Dinsey Jensen and...
That's just my phone.
Okay, also notice the camo. Jensen's partner, Jensen did the arrest in 2013 for sitting on the sidewalk, connected to Dinsey's partner,
mm-hmm.
Dinsey following me since then, realizing that what I'm saying is obviously true,
right,
and not wanting to sabotage his own political career, running for city council, trying to cover it up for those 6 years or whatever.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the connection between the 2013, my brother's barbecue, same types of abuse. They didn't like me having a sign saying,
your brother's
smear
barbecue?
For creating art.
I didn't realize that's where that happened.
My brother's isn't my brother, it's a restaurant called My Brother's.
Thank you for clarifying that, because I was like, wait, what now?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was there when I was a little kid.
Yeah?
And there were all these things associated that they were trying to cover up that I didn't know what was going on. But they were all linked to Worldwide Restaurant, so it's one jumbled ball of
shit.
Stalking.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
I have to ask you this, you're going to be mad at me.
Sure.
I have to pee really bad. When do you want me to do that?
You
want me to wait a minute?
Let's go through a few of these, because...
Okay.
We're just...
Sure, no, that's fine. I know, I was like, I've been trying to wait. I've been holding it for a while. Okay, let's do it.
Okay, important, last week on video, as we're leaving, we point out the cars
22.
With the ending plate 22s. What was the trigger mechanism?
we spoke about firewalls of Port 22,
oh.
SSH shell. Then groups of people started showing up. Either, I can't tell you specifically how they're notified, either streaming audio off my phone here, or the girl sitting across. Everyone was sitting around us because they wanted to listen to our conversation, just like the guy sat there in pink, mm-hmm. with the groups of pink showing up, because they wanted to hear the conversation so he could have texted out to these worldwide groups. Okay, he mentioned this, everyone do that, or it could have just been streamed right off my phone. The point, I can't specifically with proof show you, but the point is that there is that communication leak and then citywide groups showing up, mm-hmm. doing these things, and this starts at 94, showing that NSA level resources are built around me to notify the masses to do these things based on what I say or do.
Right.
We talk about port 22. Hey, everyone show up with cars ending in 22. And everyone in the entire citywide area comes out in these stalking groups, as we saw, right? Mm-hmm. Three Audis together, two Camrys together, three 22 ending plates together, the groups of car red cars backwards together. All
right.
Told, instantly, within seconds, based on that communication, these terror tools, rid Kevin of the world, do these things on these daily attack, these daily ramp-ups. Okay, you mentioned people wanting, this is more of a recap, you mentioned people wanting to hurt me and we didn't finish some things. I put expand on this. All sorts of references about breaking cars and dicks by the people hunting me down, my brother popping my waterbed, things
right.
like that. And using cars as analogies, I'm going to break this car, I'm going to put this car on this VW on a fire hydrant, Kevin did it.
Blaming you for everything.
Blaming me, but also sort of going after my Southern Oregon states.
Okay.
And by the way, if you want to know the reason I went to Southern Oregon State College is because the college
was bigger, right? Isn't that what you said?
No, that's
more people?
Denver or Boulder.
Bad. Sorry. Did your brother go to Southern Oregon State?
No, my brother went to University of Colorado Boulder.
Okay.
My mother, when I was 17, my mother sent me to some college counselors, which I've never even heard of college counselors if I think back.
Yeah, they have them. But.
And they had like four options. One was out of state, Southern Oregon State College, and the other ones were in state. And I chose the out of state one after looking at it. The point I'm making is that, like everything else, these decisions were manipulated.
Controlled,
does that make sense?
Kind of.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you have a list of options that are
correct.
Acceptable.
Now you okay. could go to your own options, but you're a kid and you're not. You're
no.
on autopilot.
Right, and you trust your mom.
Yeah, you trust your parents. So you understand that when they're giving you these, hey, these are the colleges I think you should go to.
You're not going to question
it. What they're really
it.
Saying is, these are controlled environments with cover-up operations.
Mm-hmm. Right, and you're not going to question
right?
or doubt that.
Correct.
At all.
And so Southern Oregon State, they're kind of hinting about my Johnson.
Oh my God!
Right,
really?
Oregon. Okay. So, or they were trying to make it look like me crying out for help or something weird like this, right?
Okay.
Cool. So these are the cover-ups. So these are the things they're trying to cover up. Okay, so all sorts of references about CART. Isn't this entire thing out of hate, anger, rage, and punishment? Isn't this like hurting people like whipping black people for not doing what you want them to do?
They're
right?
treated like less than human.
Right?
Yeah,
you associate with Melody the Stripper.
So you're...
We gotta whip you. Tim Thompson. Kevin, let's build adult websites. You, shit hits the fan. Well, you built adult websites, didn't you?
After you,
so now
yeah.
I'm gonna whip you. Right?
Even though they, like, wanted you to do
yeah,
these
so now they gotta whip me to death. For my crimes of not committing a crime.
Right, for
okay,
being...
more greens, the greens and blacks. The point is that Rhodey Morales, Tim Thompson, Victoria Wall, all of them were preying off things they knew I liked and then trying to figure out ways to sabotage and...
Any joy you have in life.
Correct. And then it just doesn't just go from adult, it goes to coffee shops or playing pool or
anything,
going to the beach,
photography, all of these passions of yours.
And so
that's terrible.
So this is all punishment out of hate and rage
for no reason
other than
you enjoying life.
Yeah, and then they play this game like, just forget it's happening and go live your life. Well, how do
they
you
won't let you
forget the whip keeps hitting you. Right?
Become numb to it, like,
yeah, and then just bleed to death.
And you said you've tried to try not to focus on it and just try to live, and it's
correct,
like,
and they get angrier and angrier. The more I focus back on my life, the larger and larger groups come after me, like the Victoria Walkers or the Nikos. Help me do this, help me do that.
Trying to draw you back in?
Correct. Now, let me give you an example. Yesterday, I went out to the beach. Got to get away from everything. Just get some fresh air.
I'm glad you did that.
Even though people follow me out to PCH, there's a good 15 or 20 people following me.
But you're trying to, like, find some peace.
Yeah, you're trying to find peace. And the valley area is kind of ramped down and it's starting to normalize.
Okay.
Then you come back at night and then it's amped up 100-fold. Why?
Because you're not there?
During the day? No, because I'll explain it from a health standpoint. You get away from the abuse, what happens?
You start feeling better.
Correct. You get healthier, you get stronger.
So when you get back, you're right
back.
So
now, you get back, you have some of your strength back.
So you can't
heal. So now, they got to ramp up their attacks to weaken you.
Right.
Okay?
So
kind of like maybe I don't come out of my house for like 3 weeks, and I go, I got some rest, and I got some of my health back, and then the local area attacks, taking walks or whatever, are now amped up a shitload.
Yeah.
Because they see, oh shit, he's getting healthy again. Okay, but once again, people don't keep whipping you while you're crawling on the ground bleeding, and then you get up and you're starting to heal, and then they grab salt and throw it in the wound.
It'd be like breaking your leg, and then you get the hard cast off, put the soft one on, then they kick you.
Like the hobbling we're talking about, right? But this isn't one crazy psychotic murderer. This is worldwide. I mean, in this parking lot alone, there's what, I don't know if you've looked, what percent would you estimate in this lot is directed to me?
There's not that many backwards cars right now.
Well, I mean,
one, two, unless I'm missing them,
you
three.
You're not really walking. Well, I'm going to tell you there's about 40%,
well,
but she's not in the lot, but I drove through videoing the lot. It'll be attached to this video of what's in the lot. There's a good 40%, let's say 20 to 40% in this lot of people directed at me that I don't know, trying to hobble me.
They want a reaction.
They want a reaction, but they also want to inflict, at the moment, pain and torture.
What do you think, like, are you, what, like, if they're trying to get this reaction, inflict all this pain and stuff, who are you supposed to be reacting on? If it's like,
all
you know what
people.
I mean? Everybody, like,
example,
smashing windows. Like,
look, how many people on this planet park in a parking lot, walk from right there to here, and there's 200 provoking, 200 passive-aggressive provokings from simply walking 50 yards. And then you sit down at a table, the guy next to your left puts one foot up on a chair, one of the tactics done for 15 years at coffee shops worldwide. The lady behind you, wow, 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 talking to her friend, wow, wow, after me
it's
talking
constant.
About the wow tactic.
Yeah.
And then the cops are showing up.
Not
if you
buying.
Even blink wrong, I'm arresting you.
Mm-hmm. Green.
Another green and black. Okay, so we've seen about 10 green and blacks.
Mm-hmm.
There's not one person on this planet this has ever been done to, except for Kevin Perlman,
that's
this scale.
What I just said, yeah.
Okay, well, if I've sat here, we've been here for about an hour.
Something like that.
40% of the lot's backwards. We've seen a good, 10, 20 greens, green and blacks. We've seen the groups of pink and blacks.
So
here comes another pink.
And they don't care what you do or who you do, whatever. They just want to see it.
Okay, in 1 hour's time, think about this. Let's be
realistic.
Let's talk about fucking reality.
Yeah.
Today alone, in 1 hour's time, there's about, let's say, 400 cars in this lot trying to set me up, provoke me. And clothing colors,
patterns,
40. That's 440 attacks. The Jamba Juice guy, they were fairly professional, but he was doing the tapping thing that they used to do when I was 29 at places worldwide.
Okay.
That's it. So, just for argument's sake, 441 people in 1 hour's time have tried to provoke me.
Yeah.
In anger.
They just want to see you react that way in any possible
How
form.
Many times per month? No. How many times for every 6 months does one person provoke you? One. In 6 months' time.
a few, handful maybe.
And that's probably, you're probably overstating, but let's just say.
No, yeah, there's definitely people who will make rude comments or cut me off or whatever, but like it's very.
But
like,
I mean personal, directed at you, not.
Oh, no.
Directed directly. Look at that fucking redhead loser. You know, like something like that.
I'm I thought you were just I was like, what is that?
I'm giving you an example.
No.
Directed, personal. Not bad drivers.
No, none. Personal. Probably.
Okay, none. Let's say one. Let's throw
one
in there.
One or two.
One or two every 6 months.
Yeah.
441 in an hour.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Okay, if 441 people per hour were provoking you, personal attacks, not.
I would.
Not you're seeing things that aren't directed at you.
I would not be able to contain myself.
Exactly.
That's why I'm saying, like, you have this crazy ability to, like, you know,
and
be
you, but it's
okay.
What are your options?
Right, that's what I'm saying.
What are your options? It's like sitting there, going like this, and someone just keeps whipping you. And you know if you react more, they're going to get 10 people to whip you. Or they're going to put you in a little cage.
Right.
So they just keep whipping you, you don't react. Now go pick my fucking cotton. Okay?
No.
You don't have a choice.
Right.
If you give them what they want, you're a dead man. Or you're in a little cage for the rest of your life.
That's what I'm saying. Even thinking about that, how you just described it, like anyone who hasn't experienced that, they would react so strongly, they'd be like, they'd blow up. I would.
Correct.
You know?
So what's the reasoning?
To blow up. Or want you to blow up.
Inflict horrific, unspeakable emotional pain till you have endless nervous breakdowns, die, can't lock yourself in a mental institution.
Or
mental
jail,
institution.
Or prison, or whatever.
Or jail, or just die. Because the human mind and body can't take 441 personal provokings per hour every day of your life.
And
this has
no
been 18/42 years for me, meaning that I found out 18 years ago at 29.
Yeah.
All day and night, 24/7, 100,000 to a million per day, personal, not Kevin seeing something that isn't there, personal attacks to hurt, harm, maim, torture, and kill. And to solidify the argument, if someone's walking by me right now and I say, excuse me, can I ask you a question? What is the reason a group of people would get together to try to torture and kill me? Their answer is going to be to torture and kill you.
Right.
Right? Okay? There is no micro-analyzing of why some psychotic murderer has managed to build an Adolf Hitler worldwide.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can, but you're just going to spin your wheels.
It'd make me crazy. I would make myself crazy.
Right?
Like,
why did Adolf Hitler kill the Jews and minorities? Why
because
did Adolf Hitler kill?
Fucked up person.
Correct.
That's why.
Okay. So now you got to leave that behind. And if someone on a court stand wants to explain that, so fucking be it. But you got to stop the fucking crime and you got to expose the crime.
Well, you got to acknowledge it first.
Yeah, just like we dropped lots of bombs on Germany and rained troops and tanks and ended up with Hiroshima and Nagasaki, even though we're taking the Japanese, you know, that's a little off topic, even though that was part of World War II, but the point is that, yes, we did defend ourselves, and yes, we didn't sit there going, we're neutral, just die, Jews.
No.
Right?
No, because that's not in our nature, you know,
to
like...
And if my family's going to try to say, well, Kevin's anti-Semitic because he's not a devout Jew, that's not a... conversation that
it doesn't even make
is
sense.
Appliable. Whether I'm Jewish, whether I'm not Jewish, whether I told my family I don't like Judaism and I went to church every day, is irrelevant to them saying we're not going to help you because of whatever reason other than we just don't like you.
Right. It doesn't.
They have no excuse.
No, zero. Where are we at?
Okay, so hate anger. You're in a situation you can't... Oh, okay, so I can tell you gotta go tinkle.
I gotta pee.
Okay, I don't understand. You're gonna have to get your bladder checked
out. I drank my whole Jamba and half the water.
Okay, you're in a situation you can't control. Oh, this is Seymour's words to me.
Oh.
When we were going to court during the trial because he kept accusing me of saying I'm a bully. And this.
Oh,
you're in a situation you can't control. Like someone zapping you with a cattle prod. He didn't say this part.
But that's, a good analogy.
The analogy, like someone zapping you with a cattle prod every 5 minutes. You can't control it, but you're going to do everything you can do to stop it. Does that make sense? So Seymour's words to me was, well, you're in a situation you can't control. And that seemed very angry and mean to me.
Well, it's like saying there's no hope, so stop trying, kind of. Right?
Correct. And then he's taking out everything that matters on the trial. And
well, you can't control it, so you might as like
just
whatever.
Die, right? Like, you can't control
so,
it.
So, like, don't care.
That's like saying the Jews in a concentration camp just give up.
No.
Well, you know your fate is probably sealed, so even
well,
more
not
so.
Give up. It's our human nature to try and survive.
Correct. You either give up and die, or before you die, you try to
survive.
Maybe you try to survive, or if you want to apply that to asking women out on dates. Well, you're not very good looking, so don't ask women out on dates because you're just gonna fail.
That's fucked up. That's stupid.
Is the same type of mentality.
Yeah.
You're just shooting yourself in the foot by thinking that way.
Exactly. You're sabotaging any chance that you...
Correct. But yeah. The problem is, it's not coming from me with low self-esteem.
Right.
It's coming from my attorney, working with every other attorney worldwide, telling me to not have self-esteem and just bow down and take it. Just like he was telling me that Kareen T. Phillips screwed up and so I should check into a mental institution
to
cover
to
up
help her, yeah.
And destroy my own life because she screwed up.
Right.
And she came after me and she screwed up.
Well,
what about my life? Where's the importance in my life?
They wants you to help her.
Help her with her. Their agenda, showing that he's involved in their agenda.
Mm-hmm. He.
Right? Now, if he's switched tunes, I can never tell you, because once you start in with that type of shit,
you can't trust
that person anymore. Okay, so we were playing musical shade seats here, although Brittany doesn't really look too comfortable, but...
No, I'm good. I'm very comfortable, actually.
Okay, so... And I don't think she has too much more time. Like usual, we haven't even got into the Golden State crap, which...
Should we start
We're gonna
with
have to just...
Time?
Yeah, we're just gonna jump right into it next time.
How far
and there's
down
always
is
things
it?
That pile on top because they're all day and night attacks. Okay, so quickly... There was a stack of magazines over there, but remember when I arrived here, people were waiting for me. One guy with a news cap, which they got angry at me at the Encino Starbucks around 2010 because I went out and I bought, I don't know what they're called, but I called a news cap. It's like a 50s.
Baseball cap?
No, it's like the, they used to wear them a lot, the news, like if you were a press guy or something. It's not just for press people, but a lot of the press people had them in the 40s
Did
with the
like
old 4x5
cap
cameras with the big flash
okay.
bulbs.
Okay.
But, you know, lots of people wear them for different reasons. I call them news hats, but they got mad. Once again, the literals, like, we don't want you wearing hats, and if you wear a hat, we're going to turn it into something. You're doing something to us, just like the shirts probably. I'm threatening people's lives with this shirt, just Jew it or whatever.
Yeah.
Or what, I don't even remember.
You're
what
representing for
right.
Yeah.
Or remember I spoke about the hat that said, be humble as if I'm somehow, and they arrested me the next day. Trying to pile all together like this guy's thugging people.
Yeah, but it's like very appropriate. Be humble.
It is appropriate,
what's wrong
but
with
they're taking things out of context.
Yeah.
They're profiling.
Right.
Oh well, Kevin showed up here and he has a be humble hat, so he's threatening people.
Right.
Telling them you better be humble. They're twisting, they're nitpicking each thing, and then twisting
contorting it,
turning into fiction, and giving out to the world on these worldwide NSA-level propaganda systems.
Right.
Right? So you're not safe, just like you're not safe to take a college class, a forensics class, where they send Eric Christian after you and Sherry Christensen after me to have me hunted and killed or eradicated. You're not safe buying a Be Humble hat or a This Is the Way We Jew
cool.
It. Shirt, or more importantly, a 21 The Lord's Gym shirt, which they're so mad about. Who would care? Because I've somehow ruined all Christians' lives, even though the newer ones I order off christianbook.com.
Really?
Showing you that the Christians
made it?
Couldn't care less. They're making them and printing them and selling them.
Right.
Showing that nobody cares, but they're taking these things that nobody cares about in their trivial pursuit to hunt me down, right? Mm-hmm. Make it look justified. Okay, so...
The woman on the front, is that what you want to talk about?
Yeah, not the woman, the... Okay, so there was a stack of these magazines. Now, I did mention Lily Zine in our last conversation.
Lily Zine.
It's an old porn star.
Oh, okay.
My family mad at me for reading Hot Rod magazine and building cars at 16 and reading books how to build cars. But more importantly, the entire reason why I grabbed the stack, which I believe they put there intentionally while the guy was waiting for me with the news hat, and there's a guy waiting, the guy was right here waiting for me with the news hat, watching everything I did, and then there were some people working on me there, and then there was the guy over there pretending like, what did he say?
He's like,
I'm part of your tribe, and he gave me like the fist punch. But when he's doing the fist punch, he's actually hinting about the Tyson picture from University of Colorado, and how I'm a violent paranoid schizo who thinks he's Mike Tyson and a woman beater.
See, I would never even like. And you're so used.
Okay,
to,
we
like,
have a honking horn twice there, and then we've had about three groups of yellows at the same time. A couple when you were in there. Okay, so go ahead. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, it's okay. No, I'm just saying like.
Correct.
You're able to see these things instantly.
And that's the point of gang stalking, is it's personal.
Right.
They're personal cryptic hints. They're not general. They're directed at you.
And
just like Brian Longbotham was working a spy game tactic on me with the world, then hiring me to work at Universal Studios on the pilot spy game to try to make it look like I conform to media. They're personal attacks. So someone sees my art. No, let me see. The entire world sees my art in secret, and then they get angry in secret, and then they try to guilt by non-direct gestures or innuendos.
Right.
But at no point, this is the,
it's never
back to the, it's either this way or that way.
Right.
You're 10 times more known than Donald Trump, but you're imagining him. Unheard of. Doesn't happen.
I was wondering in there when he asked for your name for your
game. Correct, and he knew my name. I might even have said you probably know my name, whatever. And they get mad when I say that. And they get mad when I hand them cards saying you've been lied to.
He actually took them. Did you see that?
Yeah, he was friendly.
He said thank you.
But I also he also knew that you were
right there
following me in because I saw the way he looked at you.
Okay.
And we were sitting right there in front. Okay, so the point is, that's not how people behave or act. Example. You're Kevin Perlman. I saw that picture you did on the internet from when you were in college. Mm-hmm. I think I'm disgusted at the picture. Or I like that picture, it's cool.
Or say nothing.
Or say nothing. But people don't walk by 100 people per day throwing fake punches like this, hinting that I've seen your artwork and you need to die, and then go, I don't know you.
No.
So it's strategic by nature with psychological warfare to create, to make you look paranoid. Everywhere I go, people know me. Well, did anyone say anything to you? No. You're paranoid. But in reality, that's not how things always work.
So it seems like
people don't always say direct things. If someone befriends you and they want to kill you, they don't say, oh, I just happened to befriend you because I want to kill you.
No, because right? They won't be able to get close to you.
Correct. They don't want you to know the motives or intentions.
That's horrible, though. Like, because then, like, when this all started, you started realizing, like, you had nowhere to turn.
Correct.
Go to, because you couldn't.
Correct. And when the police are involved, just like that guy pretends he doesn't know me, the police pretend they don't know me.
But they do.
They know me, they know the situation, and they don't think the situation is wrong.
Even your lawyer said stay away, they don't want to do anything.
Correct. And it's not about crazy, because if that guy over there is crazy and groups of people are hunting him down trying to kill them, it's irrelevant if the guy's crazy. The crime isn't being crazy. The crime is hunting people down to kill them. Whether they're crazy or they're not crazy, it doesn't matter.
Right.
Okay, so back to this. I picked up a magazine because I want to make a stupid point that's common sense. This picture of this girl, none of my studio photography has any nudity.
No.
I have no problem doing nudity, but I've never done any nudity.
It's all very professional.
I've been more about artistic expression. This magazine would represent my studio photography with women, except my is a lot more artistic and expressive.
It's very creative.
But the level of risque.
Yeah, I've seen your art.
Is on every shopping center, supermarket stand. And nobody could care less. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Nothing. Did it shut down?
Yeah, maybe a battery.
What time is it anyway? We have 2 minutes, too.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
why
so
didn't that work?
We're still recording.
Okay.
This battery died.
Which one? The little one?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, so the point is that, like everything else,
there's nothing wrong.
They're mad at me for things that nobody normally cares about.
That other people are doing.
Yeah. Okay. Do we really only have 2 minutes?
Mm-hmm.
Shit. Okay, so.
What's that?
Brit. Oh.
Co-work.
This is, I guess, a good finishing thing. Your co-worker was here. Your fellow therapist.
No, she's my personal therapist.
Okay, someone Brittany knew, which is very strange.
Isn't that weird?
Someone Brittany knew, or a therapist, was here. And that's a good thing because she witnessed the cops cruising by.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't know what's going on in her mind, like, it's just cops going to Starbucks. But because I'm 10 times more known than Donald Trump and everyone worldwide knows what's going on, she is really a witness as to the cops following me here.
And if she asks me about, like, what I was doing,
you should ask her. You should say, hey, I was here with Kevin, and, you know, you saw the cops cruise by. What do you think?
Okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, definitely. Get her opinion, because
I just didn't know, because
like,
that's
confidential. It's like a witness. Well, whatever. It's a witness. Well, we're on video here in public, so.
As long as it's okay with you.
Yeah, it's okay. Because she's a witness to a witness. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
You know, strengthen the argument.
Okay.
You know, ask her about the cops' behavior, how long they were in there, why she thought they sort of quickly went in and out. Whatever, right?
Okay.
And then you can
sure
mention
okay
to her, oh yeah, it's totally okay. And you can mention to her that a good 70% of the locations we go to, there's police presence. Just like the very first topic I wanted to discuss on the very top of the paper, police presence at multiple locations, and it's been a lot worse for me over the past 18 years, especially after putting the signs on my car or website, because they're playing this game like, if you do something like that, you're somehow the enemy of the state,
right. Which
is actually backwards, because I'm strengthening what we stand for, not by choice. If I had a choice, I'd be out living my life.
Be at the beach or doing whatever
you're
saying.
And making money.
Yeah.
But they put me in a position which, in order that when I have to expose them, I strengthen our national security by getting rid of things like NSA illegal operations, because NSA illegal operations are a danger to us. Now, certain parts of the government don't want to admit that because they want their control.
Right.
But the reality of the situation is too much absolute power corrupts absolutely. Too much power, too much control puts you into a state like the movie 1984 or Germany 1940s. And technology is just getting better with deep learning and all the basic level AI algorithms now with Google and NVIDIA, and the college is just going crazy with these basic level neural processors like NVIDIA is pumping out. And you can only imagine what they're capable of doing in NSA and the government now, based on just the things I research for graphics and the algorithms they're writing.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
But so the things that Edward Snowden talks about as 10-year-old technology isn't even close to what we can do now, based on profiling algorithms with basic level artificial intelligence on these extremely complex basic level neural processors like the NVIDIA Tensor cores. It's just, there's probably all sorts of crazy, insane things going on in the government that we don't know about. But anyways, the point is that without checks and balances, we're just going to become into a Nazi state. And most people are like, yeah, whatever, the U.S. is the best place in the world. Well, no, the U.S. was the best place in the world around the 40s and the Industrial Revolution. And now China and all these countries are surpassing us, India and China. And China pays all our bills. I mean, we're in debt so far now because our entire government are a bunch of ass puppets who have no clue what the fuck's going on, except I want control and power, and that's all they know. And so that's the reality of the situation. Now, if people want to watch the paid-off propaganda press, like Fox News with the right-wing agendas and MSNBC, with the left-wing agendas, they're going to be fed the information on the surface of what the government and politics want you to believe. And so once you start thinking for yourself and looking at, without going total Glenn Beck, but thinking about what could happen, and based on my situation and based on what Edward Snowden came forward about, you need to understand that the ass puppets at the top have no goddamn clue what they're doing, and most of them just want power or control and to win. And without rational, sane people at the top, very important or very aggressive decisions are being made without these checks and balances, which your life can end up like mine for no reason at all.
Okay,
so that's pretty much,
I'm sorry, I'm just curious what your
I'm just talking about my life and the illegal government operations that destroyed my life. Them not wanting me to talk. Check out the website. It explains everything and tons of video.
I'm an activist.
Okay.
And me and my friend Zafir, we are planning a march in about 6 months. And it's calling for global unity.
Okay, good.
That's good. We're going to be doing other smaller kind of activist disruptions, I guess.
Okay.
It's more peaceful than that, but I don't know what the word demonstrations, I guess.
Yeah, that's good. No, and, freedom of speech. That's good.
Our first one is going to be in August.
Okay.
So I'll send you information about
that. Okay, yeah, definitely. There's an email on the website, info@kevinperlintarget.com. You can reach
me. All right.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Bye.
Okay, so I guess you have to go.
Yeah.
And
oh, go ahead. Sorry.
Yeah, I'm just going to shut this off. Okay, so we're shut now, whatever. I think I already said that. Blah, blah, blah.
Okay, so it looks like groups of white cars. Okay, so we have a black and white Mercedes together. Okay. Okay. Then these appear to be like groupings of whites, but you know, that might or might not be. Okay, so two Priuses, I think, around here. You can see the black and white Mercedes together, which is more obvious than the spread groups of about nine black ones, right? But it shows you what's going on. Two Priuses right on this side, kind of surrounding my car, but not directly together. Okay, so as we leave, two Hondas together here, a third one, I think they're all like Civics. Let's see. Okay, there's my car. Someone put something on it, but do I even give a shit? Oh, they're just cars. They're angry at me passing out cards. Okay, so Honda Accord, Toyota Camry. Okay, so Honda Civic. Two Honda Civics here. And this guy, lady's still waiting. She could be picking someone up, but I doubt it. And this guy's still, is he still waiting here? No, looks like he left. And the two Mercedes together, right? Camry, and nothing there. Okay, so they're angry that I'm passing out cards to the people who are working on me with the mental illness tactics, right? So they bring out the cards, they park them in twos, cards are passed out, then they get angry. You're passing out cards. Well, yeah, because you're doing these things with the cards to create mental illness. Two golds together there, right? Another gold here. Technically a black pickup on this side as well, right? Oh, this truck across from this truck in twos, right? So when they're sitting there getting mad at me, they're not mad at the things they're doing to me, right? So here's our truck and our truck. They're not mad at the things they're doing to me to try to create mental illness and kill me. That's okay.
just don't tell anyone what's being done to you, right? If you understand. Because you're ruining our lives by saying something about it, right? That's the thought process, right? Two gold cars there. Now, even if I were to pull to the side of the road right here, they'd get angry. Just, right? Ooh, girls didn't shoot. Showing that it doesn't matter what I do, they just want me dead and gone. There's no actual reason. Okay, we're gonna document the lot as we come out like usual. We're by a CVS pharmacy. I think this is, we're gonna notice the right PJ, whatever the fuck that is, PT Cruiser. We're gonna document, okay, notice the second yellow car in twos, right? So there are kind of groupings of yellow cars. We are at the right location. Okay, so this is just sporadic cars forwards and backwards in different directions. I'm trying to figure this out. I don't think I'm gonna be able to park another X Tierra. We're out in Westlake now. Another X Tierra backwards. Right, notice how they're using the X Tierras. We're not going to be able to use the car DVRs. Okay, I'm just sorting out the reds in this aisle. Right, there's no reds in any other aisle. Just this aisle. Right, very important. Okay, first let's find a parking spot. Okay, two Audis together. One girl's waiting in the Audi, in the gray one. Okay, so the two Audis together. These cars are kind of similar in shape. You might want to say they're trying to get similar things together like they always do. They probably are. Gray Mercedes here, parking backwards by the yellow Beetle. All directed at me, whether I'm coming here or not. Okay, so this is pretty crowded, so we're probably gonna have to get a seat now. Okay, so that's what we're gonna do. And there's no place to really park with my DVR pointing, but that's okay, we don't need to. More Porsche Carrera, Porsche Cheyenne. See the kind of groupings of people who have Porsches together? Right? Things are more sporadic and spread here, so it's harder to prove. Which is really being done worldwide. But, you know, they strategically follow me to the places I go to. Okay, so there's none of the aggressive things like some of the other lots that I'm pointing out that are provable. Easier to prove, I should say. So let's just, I guess, park here. Now this is crowded, so okay. Okay, so it's crowded, so I'm just gonna go in now. Okay, so as we leave, a guy in green and black just pulled up. The person's waiting for me in this Mazda 3 or whatever it is. And behind this car, there's another one parked backwards. They're waiting for me to leave. I kind of pointed it out to Brittany. There's another, I think, Mazda here, so you're kind of seeing the groupings of Mazdas as I'm leaving and who have parked strategically as we're leaving, or as I'm here, strategically with the mental illness tactics. Um,
quickly drive down this way. Here's the other one parked backwards by my car. So there's this one, there's this one, there's the one behind over there. There's probably a lot more. Let's kind of cruise around. Another Jeep Ranger. White Jeep Ranger, across from the Jeep Ranger, a white Jeep Cherokee. I was pointing out this guy before, this XTR with the groupings of XTRs, strategically following me, parking cars where places I'm going to go or go. Another backwards Jeep Cherokee here. Right there. And look at the large groupings of cars all towards where you enter. All backwards. We've had police presence trying to intimidate me in Ventura County here. And when the police walked in, I'm not 100% sure, we talked about it on camera, whether or not he bought a coffee or he quickly walked into Starbucks asking questions. That's very important. Okay, we're having larger rates of yellow shirts come show up at the same time. Reds and twos here, right, together, and higher groupings of reds in this area by the Vons. As we're leaving the lot, right here, more backwards Mazdas, right? So you see a pattern with these Mazdas all throughout this lot, and other lots. Once we get back here, this guy's even waiting in the car, actually, for me, in the little Mini Cooper, the same ones they park around my house. The red ones, like that. Over here, we have two, a black and a white truck together. Right? A black and white. Two different trucks together. I don't know which way this lot goes. Now we're going way the hell away from where I was, but I guarantee that we're still gonna have these same tactics and patterns directed at me. Another Jeep Ranger, another red Jeep Cherokee, more Jeep Cherokees. Some of these are, some of them aren't. It's not as obvious over here. Red car backwards, red Altima backwards to a red Jeep Cherokee. And once again, there's a guy sitting in the red Altima, just like the guy sitting in the the red Mini Cooper, right? There's even a girl standing there. She should be on camera with a chill shirt waiting for me to come out this way. And two white cars backwards together here. Okay, so now you're saying, but wait, Kevin, you're not even near the Jamba and Starbucks you just left. You're on the totally opposite side where normally you wouldn't even leave going out this way. So why are they all the way out here waiting for you, even though we're technically in the same huge parking lot. Okay, look at the twos and threes and groups backwards. Same with across from it. And the answer is they do this worldwide, everywhere. So I spend all day and night watching mass stalking groups stalking me and then going, you're imagining it. And then they play this game like we're on your side or something. Okay, two white Jeep Cherokees together, and the girl with the chill shirt was right down there, right? And then the two backwards cars here together in the pairs of twos tactic. Okay, now just noting another Jeep Cherokee over there. More Mazdas, which may or may not be. All these cars here, most of them look forwards now that we're further away. Oh, here comes the Mini Cooper, the guy that's waiting for me over there. He's in his car on the phone, coming out this direction. Mazda here leaving. I think this is the... Oh. Okay, this is the redhead girl playing doubles with Brittany. Wants me to go to a rally or activist thing, except she sat in the same spot I did with Brittany. And, saying amazing, amazing, or something like that. Pretending she didn't know who I was. And that's rude to say, I don't know who you are, be part of our thing, when you can't admit that Kevin Perlman, who is 10 times more known than Donald Trump, you refuse to acknowledge the situation, but you want me to help you with your situation. Right? Okay, so we've kind of looped around, and now we're leaving. Now, just for the fuck of it, let's go across to this shopping center across and check out how cars are parked. And it's probably the same. White pickup backwards there, black pickup backwards there. White pickup backwards here, red pickup backwards there, gold pickup backwards here. These are just the things that are catching my eye really quick. Okay. That's where the Jamba and Starbucks is across the street. Gray pickup backwards here, gold pickup backwards here, let's go a little more thorough now, because we've seen about 10-15 pickups backwards in this lot, just instantly. Something like that, I'm not sure. This aisle looks normal. Mercedes, red and black backwards. Okay, this is the red and white pickups we saw earlier backwards. I don't think we saw this black pickup backwards. Yeah, we did. This black pickup with that white pickup. Also on video, we talk about, when we first start recording, we talk about Nico mentioning pickups. She has a pickup in front of her house. Okay, so I think we probably got the majority of backwards pickups, but you can see black Jeep Cherokee, maybe, maybe not. More Mazdas, maybe, maybe not. Jeep by a Mini Cooper, maybe, maybe not. I mean, the one backwards is, obviously. The car cover. Car backwards, car cover, just noticing that. We're coming towards the back of the shopping center. It's getting more normal. Still some cars backwards, but a lot more normal. The big one you need to question is, why is there a group of pickups in the front backwards all in the same area? That's the big main question. And a cute girl. And a cute girl with tattoos. Okay, Jeep Ranger backwards there. Right? So that's a lot of anger for one guy with planets full of people trying to kill him. Okay, we're going to Thousand Oaks Fish and Chips here. People are gonna follow me in anger, rage, like everywhere else. Hold on. Ritz. 3. And there's two cars here backwards together. There's actually a third one across ramp. There's going to be a lot more showing up, like everywhere else you've seen worldwide. Notice this row, all the cars backwards, and the Jeep Cherokee, and then one here, or a car here, backwards. Now we're gonna go and get food. People are gonna follow me like usual. You've seen in the last parking lot how many people were waiting for me inside the parking lot. So they're all gonna probably follow me out here, just like this guy across from me in the infinity waiting. Now also notice two backwards pickups here, right? So you're seeing the pattern of pickups. Everywhere I go worldwide, especially amped up today with pickups, to try to torture and kill me. But no reason. Okay, so we have cars pulling up now as I'm leaving. I wasn't here too long. Tommy's Floor and Carpet, who is hinting about Tom Farley and me talking about the guys at the cigar shop spitting on my floor as tobacco last Monday, I think. We have another guy with an active sticker parking backwards on the other side of this.
who a girl, a Brittany lookalike, is asking me if I want to be an activist with her while trying to pretend she's like Brittany, a redhead sitting at the same table we were at. And then coming up asking what we were talking about is she doesn't know who I am in these worldwide murder operations. Like wanting me to kiss her ass and do shit for her. So as you can see, I've been here about 10 minutes. Cars are now showing up. Okay, so this is the guy that pulled up with the active sticker. He's waiting with the car on next to the Tommy's carpet, like some kind of hidden message about the girl that asked me to take part in being an activist with her, and then the Tom Farley hinting car. We're fighting against Tom Farley schizophrenia messages, if you understand the things they're doing. And then they, for some reason, can't comprehend, or at least they say they can't comprehend, that this is wrong. Trying to make me think that it's my fault they're hunting me. Okay, so the guy's in the car, I believe, waiting with it on, trying to intimidate me. And so we're just gonna get some video of him. Because you're gonna follow people from place to place, trying to kill them with mass groups, you might as well get video of them. So here he is. Is it a black dude? Looks like a black guy, so you understand that it is black people hunting down Jews. I mean, it's everyone, but part of these groups are all predominantly black. So we're gonna quickly drive by Brittany's lot. Remember, there's usually two or three cars backwards by the door to her lot. Okay, red car's backwards here. Directed at me. This is the H home, do it yourself, home, whatever. Okay, I don't feel like driving through the lots, but we're gonna video the lots and what these people are all doing. Okay, look at the amount of cars backwards. Now we're gonna go to Brittany's lot. Right now, a lot of them are more forwards. Okay, we're coming to the center lot here. Two or three backwards usually. Let's see what we have. And some Jeep Rangers. One big truck backwards. And that's it. And then there's another red car over here backwards, just like you saw a red car in the other lot over to the left backwards. Okay, right now most of the lot is normal. And then if we go to the right here, it's gonna be aggressively backwards like usual. Okay, so we'll just kind of double back. And we'll go out this way. And document this lot. and how aggressive it is with the mental illness tactics. Pairs of twos together there backwards with a red American flag. Okay, we're by the cigar shop, and the guy following me just now is obviously associated with the cigar shop people. Now, I just want to point out, the cigar shop's that way. I'm gonna point out all the cars locally around here and them ramping up their Jeep Rangers and Jeeps and things like this as we drive by the cigar shop. The other day we also videoed this shopping center. Let's see if we can get in the shopping center. Actually, we'll do a loop around. We can. Okay, so we'll do a loop around. See how many Jeep Cherokees. Remember that we had the red Mini Cooper in here last week, or Monday, or whatever the hell it was. Now, surprisingly, the shopping center here looks fairly normal, but out here looks a little strange. Right, okay, so Jeep Black Escape, Black Jeep. We're gonna go back here. Look at the cars kind of backwards here. Do we have any Jeeps down here? No, this isn't too bad right here. Oh. But at the corner there, you can see the Jeeps. Right, the two cars backwards here in pairs of twos. Black Jeeps or Escapes, same car. Okay, so let's video our surrounding. Okay, so now let's drive through quickly through the lot. This Audi looks like he's doing the same thing. Probably sees me. A red car behind me. Let's see. Okay, so let's look for the pairs of twos and the patterns. Jeep Cherokee by itself. Backwards Jeep Ranger over here. So back to the Jeep Rangers. There's another guy waiting for me in a gold pickup over here. Over there. White Jeep Cherokee, I think that's the second one, right? We had a guy, yellow and black, over here, where the death threats were a long time ago. I don't talk or they'll kill me. Let's take a look at the rest of the lot here. Not all the cars are forwards. We have a gray and black. Okay, over here we have larger groupings and pickups backwards. Remember the pickups backwards all today. Okay, Jeep Escape, Jeep Cherokee, same cars. Third Jeep, right? So tons of Jeeps. This guy must work here because the Saturn's always here. Views. The big one up front here is the yellow and black. And Sue Mama, whatever. We'll sort of point out the Audis, whatever, even though there's just one. And so that's kind of it. As we go back the other way, one of the Jeeps is leaving in these groupings of Jeeps. Most of these are fairly normal, but that guy waiting for me over there is obvious. Two red cars in the corner here. The Jeep Ranger, white Jeep Ranger. The second white Jeep Ranger backwards here with the backwards gold pickup. Backwards Kia, red Mazda, person waiting in it. Right. Obviously these two white Rangers are strategic. Guy waiting for me, strategic. Another Jeep here. This is all directed at me. Oh, a blue person waiting in a blue. A Mazda here and a person waiting in a blue Escape there for me. I quickly want to video this parking lot because they've had trucks backwards in the past, tons of them. And the first thing we see is a gray pickup backwards. A white pickup backwards. It's a big lot, so it's hard to... I think I see a pickup down. Okay, pickup backwards. Pick up backwards.
Sure, I'm still video recording here, yeah.
Mazdas, backwards. We're seeing lots of Mazdas and pickups today. The pickup in my mirror, he's parking backwards as we're looping around. Let's see if we can get him so you can kind of see how they all kind of know what to do. Whatever, he's just one of a billion. Jeep Ranger, but he's forwards and not in large groups. Oh, a second black Jeep Ranger. Okay, two black Jeep Rangers together. Remember, I was just driving to fucking random lots. Okay, Jeep, two black Jeep Rangers together strategically. More Mazdas, two together. Mazdas together. These aren't random cars. Okay, we're coming towards closer to the end of the lot. Once again, more backwards pickups. This one over here is forwards. They start to get a little more normal at the end here. Okay, so I just happened to be driving out this way and I noticed this parking lot here had some backwards pickups in it. So, the X-Tierras, yellow X-Tierras, one forward and one backwards pickup here. We're at Pete's Coffee now. Do we have pickups? We have a backwards GMC. Oh yeah, it is a pickup. Backwards pickup here. Person waiting for me here, kind of waiting by the pickup, she's on the phone. We're behind now. So two backwards pickups right here. These groups of people in pickups backwards. More a white pickup here backwards. A Jeep Ranger and another pickup backwards. A car behind him backwards, but the provable ones, obviously, are all the pickups backwards today. I don't know what this is. It's a restaurant or something. Okay, pickup. Pick up Jeep Ranger backwards. And as we're about to leave, I think there's a coffee bean around here. Probably has more pickups backwards. Wait, I think we want to go this way. Thousand Oaks Tobacco. Okay, another pickup backwards. This is the coffee bean over here. So what's the number of pickups backwards today in Thousand Oaks? Um, Oof. Okay, so there's our pickup backwards. So they'll tell you I'm making them do this. That's their argument. I'm making them do these things. Let's figure out how to get out of here. Black trucks backwards. We're about to go on the freeway. I'm just gonna zip through this one parking lot here. Pick up backwards. Notice I'm going through lot after lot in Thousand Oaks. Pick up backwards, pick up backwards. Okay, cars in twos backwards. Psycho two, that's about right. Okay, that's the truck backwards. Right, almost every lot in Thousand Oaks, trucks pickups backwards. Okay, there's a Starbucks here and a Sharky's. The Mazdas, we're back to the Mazdas, backwards, and groupings of Mazdas. Remember, these Mazdas all start in Woodland Hills. We're now in Thousand Oaks. How fast they're disseminating information worldwide to have me killed. Just note the Ranger, there's an awful lot of Rangers when I barely ever see Rangers. Okay, Pick up backwards. Oh, and the XTR by the G. And I go to that bakery a lot to get coffee a lot of times too. So if you want to understand some of those connections. Jeep Cherokee backwards. And then that's pretty much the lot. Once again, a random lot. Oh, pick up backwards. Okay, so there you go. Okay, we're quickly going to video the police sheriff station here, how the cars are parked. To show you, we're out in Thousand Oaks, Olson Road. I'm just gonna show you how they're taking part and pretending it's not happening and I'm imagining it and crazy. Like we have so much other video footage. Okay, this is the guest parking area. Right now in the guest parking, everything looks kind of normal. I am focused on the red Explorer here, but Nothing super out of the norm, no backwards. No backwards or pairs of twos. And this is where you would park if you were a guest to go into the police station. Now let's go into the police station parking with the police officers. Very important. Employee vehicles only. We already see a car backwards. Usually we see trucks together and trucks backwards. A DART car is charging, that doesn't quite count. Disaster assistance response. Okay, we have two backwards trucks over there. Backwards police truck over here. Backwards black truck over here. I don't know who drives that Lambo in a police station. Backwards pink Hummer. Backwards pickup here. All right, you see the pattern with pickups. Okay, backwards Ranger. Backwards black pickup, backwards blue pickup. And let's just do one last loop around. This road looks fairly normal, minus one backwards Accord. And two motorcycles in the corner. Okay. So, I think you can agree, especially with 70% of the pickups in this lot backwards in the police station, that the police are behind these illegal operations. This is the Olson Road, Ventura County. Olson Road, Ventura County, Sheriff and Police. And I'm just getting video of the things they're involved in that they say I'm imagining. Which all of the police employees you can see are doing it, what I'm imagining.